It's a pleasure to introduce this next person. Joining us now on the Notre Dame Hotline is someone who knows a thing or two about winning. He quarterbacked Notre Dame to a national championship in 1966 and then went on to the NFL. While at Notre Dame, he was a three-year starter and consensus All-American in 1968. But yet as an 18-year-old sophomore, he was featured on the cover of Time magazine. Terry Hanratty, welcome to Notre Dame Day.
Well, thank you, Digger. It's great to be part of this wonderful program.
Well, thanks.
I just hope we don't talk about rodeo.
No. No, you rode a lot of horses in your day when you played quarterback. You know that. But anyhow, let's start talking about the recruiting process. How does a guy from Butler, PA, outside of Pittsburgh, end up choosing Notre Dame to come play college football?
It's really, you know, it's so different than what it is today, where you have all these camps you go to and all the four stars, the five stars, the three stars, and all that stuff. Back then, it was just what you did on the field, and it was pretty much word of mouth. And we had a really good team. You know, Butler High School was, you know, I would say one of the best high schools, football-wise, in the country. You know, we had, I think, my coach in 20 years had 62 Division I players, and I was about in the middle of that crowd. And so just word of mouth, and Arrow saw my film, and, you know, I don't even know who sent it to Arrow, but he saw my film, then he came to Pittsburgh, and I met him, and I'd almost committed to Michigan State about a week prior to that. And then once I met Arrow, you know, it was all over.
Well, you know, going back when, you and Jim Seymour were close friends until he passed away in 2011. But tell us about that friendship, but more importantly, he was your target when you're throwing the ball. He was the guy catching them all. Both you guys were featured on the cover of Time magazine together. Get into that mode.
Well, if I want to put myself back into 1966 in this cover, we know it's come. If Notre Dame did not want it to be publicized. If you're going to put anybody on the cover of Time magazine, they wanted Nick Eddy, they wanted Jim Lynch, they wanted Pete Duranko, some of the great seniors we had on the team, the guys that really deserved it a lot more than Jimmy and I, because, you know, they protected us, they got us the ball, and, you know, we were both, you know, staring at each other, you know, what this is, you know, almost embarrassing, you know, the way the big feature, the cover, and Notre Dame didn't want it, and for Time magazine to get it on there, they did a sketch of our faces. Notre Dame would not supply them with any,
wow,
you know, pictures of
right.
Jimmy and I. So they did their own sketch because they wanted, you know, these two young guys to be on the cover, so... You know, it didn't hurt because we went on to win the national championship, and we had, you know, one of the great teams of all time.
But as smart as Arrow was, and you guys remember the game of the century, you're up at Michigan State, and it ends in a 10-10 tie, and it was just, let's get the tie and get out because we're still going to be in position to win a national championship, which you did. But talk about that 10-10 tie because you had to come back to tie that game.
Well, very, very few people realize that that was not a nationally televised game. Back then, you could be on national TV three times in a two-year period. And we had already been on national TV with our opener against Purdue. And so what ABC did was that they blacked out, I think it was North Dakota and South Dakota. That way they could call it a regional game, which is, you know, a true story.
Yes.
I may have the states wrong, but, you know, yes. that's the concept of it. And, you know, it was something that you really didn't, you know, to us, it really was just another game. I mean, we knew we were going to play a great team in Michigan State and going up there. But Harris sort of, he was so great at deflecting all the pressure off the
right.
players, where he took all the pressure, you know, before and after the game, whether win, lose, or draw. You know, Harris was, you know, it was him. And, you know, so it was one of those, you know, crazy games where, you know, I separated my shoulder in the first quarter, you know, a miss hit by Bubba Smith. And, you know, then Nick Eddy fell off the train when we got there, and he hurt his shoulder. George Gedeke, our starting All-American center, he left the game early with an injury. You know, so we were a little decimated, but, you know, I still say the two best teams ever to play each other. If you look at the amount of All-Americans and, you know, all the guys went on to the pros and first and second round picks and whatnot and have great, you know, all pros, you know, type careers, and those are two great teams.
Well, after your pro career with the Steelers and two Super Bowl rings, you took on the challenge to take on Wall Street. Tell me what that was like.
You know, it was interesting because I was in the trading area of it, where you see, desk, where you used to see the madness on the floor of the exchange, where we were the semi-sane people upstairs that would, tell them what to do, what to buy, what to sell, when to do it. And it was a really easy transition because, you're constantly, trading hundreds of thousands of shares, but you have to do it fast. It's really fast. By the end of the day, at 4 o'clock hits, you are tired. But the background that I had with being a quarterback and making decisions in 3 seconds, it made it a lot easier for me because, you could live, if you threw an interception, you had to figure about the interception right now. If you didn't get the price you wanted on your stock, you forget about it and go back to the next area. So it was a pretty easy transition for me. I enjoyed it.
Well, one more question about you as a quarterback, but your son ends up coming here to play as a lineman. And tell me about that experience with Connor.
It was just phenomenal. I think, Connor is 6'5". At the time, he was 3'10". Now, thank God he's down to about 255. He's lost a lot of weight. And he'll have his MBA in about 2 weeks.
There you go.
And so it was fun. I think he played really well. He did, I think, beyond everybody's expectations. And, I was so proud to watch him play in a Notre Dame uniform and come through that tunnel. Believe me, there's a tear in Dad's eye. But it was just, phenomenal years that he had there. And, they had a lot of success, a lot of victories. And it was just something, very that we could share forever for.
Well, Terry, I've got to thank you being on this show. You're one of the great legends of Notre Dame football, especially when you talk about what you did playing for Eric Parsegian, one of the great coaches ever in Notre Dame football history with Leahy and Rockne. But more importantly, your whole lifestyle here and after here is what this place is all about. And thanks for being a part of Notre Dame Day.
Well, thank you, Digger. I appreciate it.